Save your God, nations come. God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Together, let us honestly and humbly confess that we have not lived as God desires. Loving and forgiving God,
we confess that we are held captive by sin. In spite of our best efforts, we have gone astray. We have not welcomed the stranger. We have not loved our neighbor. We have not been Christ to one another. Restore us, O God. Wake us up and turn us from our sin. Renew us each day in the light of Christ. Amen.
People of God, hear this glad news. By God's endless grace, our sin is forgiven, and we are free. Free from all that holds us back, and free to live in the peaceable realm of God. May you be strengthened in God's love, comforted by the Christ's peace, and accompanied with the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Long
Hundreds and hundreds of years before Jesus was born, there are two prophets, Micah and Isaiah.
What is a prophet?
A prophet is someone that shares information from God with us, sometimes something that will happen in the future.
How do we know that what they said?
The stories of the prophets are part of the Old Testament, or the Hebrew Bible.
So we have these two prophets, Micah and Isaiah.
From you, Bethlehem, will come the one who will rule Israel, a wonderful leader for the whole world. He will be a good shepherd who loves and takes care of each sheep in his flock. He will take care of all people and lead with love and mercy.
The Lord will give you a sign, young woman will bear a son and shall name him Emmanuel.
Thank you.
says that we're born in a baby. Among the straw and animals in the stable, there were probably cows, sheep, and donkeys, and probably some other animals.
I And that is how a little baby born in Bethlehem brought together prophets, angels, fairies, the deliverer, the innkeeper, animals, shepherds, the Christmas star, and green magi, all into one Christmas story.
Jesus came down to bring us love, life, peace, and joy.
Let us offer our thanks and joy for us.
Thank you.
from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
With hope and expectation, we offer our prayers to the church, the world, and all who awaits God's day of restoration.
Peace with one another. on the tree today. It's also a special week in that it is Marilyn's birthday. So, happy birthday to Marilyn. And Jory.
Happy birthday to you.
It is nearing the end of the year, so if you're a member of private financial services and haven't used up your action plans, please do so. We've got ideas. If you don't know what I'm talking about, private members get two $250 gift cards annually to spend on something. At the very least, if you have it left over, we can buy things for the Smithtown Food Pantry. So if you're a private member and maybe you don't know if you've used that yet, please come talk to me or talk to Bob. Thank you, and we'll get those.
We'll buy the food if you get the cards.
Thank you, Bob. Thank you, Bob. January 21st, we'll be having a Reconciling in Christ forum with someone who's from another congregation who's gone through this process before. We're inviting you to submit questions on this process in the box in the entryway. And second to last, today we're having a little experiment with coffee hour, so I've been asked to let you all know that the big jug is regular coffee and the small carafe is decaf coffee. If you don't get that right, you're going to have some hyper people running later on. Lastly, as we headed to communion, you did hear in the prayers that we prayed for the family of Ruth Schaffler, who did pass away. Her funeral is tomorrow here at 11 a.m. And likewise, that some of you may recognize the name Jeff Fay, who was Calvary Youth Director many, many, many years ago. He also passed away just a week and a half ago. And so more information will be shared as we have it. There's no information at this time, but please keep the Fay family in your prayers. Yes?
Are we decorating the tree at the church?
Yes, you did just announce that. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. But, Janine, we're decorating the tree. Yes, all good, all good. So as we come to the God's table, we find yet another place where God meets us here in bread and wine to continue with our offering.
Thank you. Emmanuel, we pray.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. You comforted your people with the promise of the Redeemer, through whom you will also make all things new in the day when he comes to judge the world in righteousness. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you.
for us, and we rejoice. In this bread and cup, you give us life forever. In your boundless mercy, strengthen us and open our hearts to the world's needs. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Receive this blessing. The Creator of the stars, bless your Advent waiting. The long-expected Savior, fill you with love. The unexpected Spirit, guide your journey, now and forever.
Amen.
Of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.